Hi, my name is Chris Sterrett. I'm a doctor at Holtorf Medical Group, Pasadena. Today I'd like to talk about Hashimoto's thyroiditis. Hashimoto's thyroiditis is the most common cause of hypothyroidism today. The reason that's not diagnosed in many people is because their doctors don't check for it. Why don't they check for it? Because there's really nothing they feel they can do for it. Hashimoto's thyroiditis is an autoimmune thyroiditis. That means that your body actually makes antibodies that attack your thyroid gland. Just like many other autoimmune diseases, I'm sure you're familiar with. You've heard of things like rheumatoid arthritis or multiple sclerosis or lupus. These are all autoimmune diseases that attack different parts of your body. Well, in Hashimoto's thyroiditis, there are antibodies that attack the thyroid gland. Little by little, the thyroid gland will be destroyed and form fibrous tissue. At first, the antibodies will start to destroy the thyroid gland, and it will release maybe more thyroid hormone. So you can, at the beginning, alternating bouts of hypothyroid and hyperthyroid. Hyperthyroidism would be when you were feeling anxious, your heart's racing, you feel hot all the time. Hypothyroidism are the typical symptoms people are familiar with. Feel tired all the time, feel sluggish, don't want to get up in the morning, feel cold, you lose hair, your nails are thin and brittle, and even constipation. And for the treatment of Hashimoto's thyroiditis, one thing we want to do is treat for hypothyroidism. So, if you're feeling sluggish, and we find that people, even if their thyroid isn't quote unquote way out of range, and people have a level of, let's say, thyroid labs that their doctor wouldn't treat them for, we find that treating them, even if their labs are quote unquote normal, makes them feel better. And then we have ways also to lower the antibodies.